What's going on, guys, and welcome back to the Title Thrills YouTube channel. It has been 9 months since I've said that, and I'm very excited to finally be back here, and it is go time. Today is September 7th, 2024, and I am here in the parking lot of Six Flags Fiesta, Texas, and we are going to be going to Fright Fest today. It's opening day of Fright Fest. And I'm so excited, you guys. I am so excited. I've got my orange shirt on. I've got my Dr. Diabolical hat on. I'm wearing Halloween socks. Can I do like this real quick? I'm wearing Halloween socks. Can't really see them that well, but they're there. And I'm very excited. There's a lot of brand new stuff at Fright Fest this year. And I am so excited to finally get in there and experience everything that Fright Fest and Boo Fest has to offer. So I'm super excited. Let's get this video started. Oh, I'm so excited to be back and back at Fright Fest. We're back, baby. So as we're walking into that front entrance, check out that brand new sign over there, guys. That looks incredible. I've seen pictures of it. This is my first time seeing it in person. That thing looks incredible. Holy cow. The skull one was pretty cool, but this one is next level, unreal. So very cool sign. That's how you know it's about to go down this year with Fright Fest. Look, there goes Goliath. It's not open just yet, but yep, there it is. There is a chaperone policy going in effect starting today. All guests ages 15 or younger must be accompanied by a chaperone that is 21 or older starting at 4 p.m. So great way of helping keeping Fright Fest pretty safe. I know there's been some stuff happening in the past. So well done, Six Flags, well done. All right, let's go to security. So we are in the park now, and one of the brand new things that's happening for Fright Fest, or should I say Boo Fest this year, the whole front of the park is completely Boo Fest themed out. So now it is more themed to Dia de los Muertos, or the Day of the Dead for my non-Spanish speakers. There's a lot of really cool decorations around here, and I'm loving it. It's so cool. So yeah, there's more stuff over in Texas State Square, but we'll head over there in just a second. But yeah, look at all these cool stuff around here. How awesome. So one of the things I'm most excited for today is going to be over here. I don't know why it doesn't show the signs out right now, but Haunted Hollywood is a brand new show here at Zaragoza Theater. No more Zombie Prom, which kind of sucks, but I'm excited for Haunted Hollywood. It's going to feature a lot of songs from different movies and stuff, and so very excited for that. Looks like the first show, I believe, is at 2:30 today, so I'm very excited to watch the first production of that right here at Zaragoza Theater. So like always with Fright Fest, you do have to purchase the Fright Pass. To get into all the haunted houses. It is $35 and the Express Pass is $45. I went ahead and bought the All Season Fright Pass. I might as well go redeem it right now since I'm here, but yeah, let's go redeem it. Look how these guys have moved over here. These guys used to be under the bridge by the train over there, but now they've moved over here. Makes sense because it's Dia de los Muertos themed. These guys creep me out. But check out all the cool decor around here for this really cool area. Absolutely gorgeous. Ooh, I love this song. Copyright. Check this out, guys. This is super cool. I'm gonna miss Soul Harvest, but this is really cool. Very pretty stuff. Wonder if they're gonna do anything around here. Teatro's gone through a little bit of a makeover, so no more Caliente, which was the summer show, and now they have Fiesta de los Muertos. I believe this show is gonna be just the mariachis, Los Soberanos, the mariachi band that plays here a lot. I thought I've heard about this show. But yeah, this is gonna be the first show we watched today, so that's exciting. But yeah, stage looks pretty. Dude, check this thing out. This looks like the new entrance for Fear Acres, which is the extreme scare zone that's back here in Whitewater Bay. Get out of here, this is cool. Looks like they reused the Soul Harvest shack and then put the Fear Acres sign on it. This is cool. You can kind of see all the stuff that's back there for Fear Acres. That's the exit for Fear Acres, but there's more like shacks and stuff back here. This is an extreme scare zone, so it's kind of like a mixture between a haunted house and a scare zone. It's all outdoors, basically wind through the water park over here, and you get to experience some scares. So we should see our boy Barnabas over here later on tonight. Oh, there goes Cliffhanger. Is there? Oh, I see that. Oh, there's a train. Let's see if we can see any of the shacks. Oh yeah, I can see a few of them. Can't really see it too well because the trees are covering it. That's the first one that you walk into. I'm excited for Fear Acres. I don't know if I'm gonna do it tonight with all the timing and stuff, but I'm excited for Fear Acres. So as we head into Crack Axle Canyon, we can hear the Dr. Diabolical's Cliffhanger going right now. And here is our first haunted house. It is Slaughterhouse 6 Extreme making a return this year. And yeah, oh, they have a new little pop-up sign for it too. That's kind of nice. But the entrance is over back that way. But yeah, Slaughterhouse is interesting. I think it's one of the weaker houses here, but it's a very interesting house. I don't know if I'll get to do it tonight, but if I not tonight, then definitely tomorrow night. Looks like Iron Rattler might be closed, which sucks, but yeah. So now we're kind of in the steampunkin' scare zone area. This is where the Dead Enders, the Sliders, like to make their home. And we have the first of the two new houses this year. Six Flags is doing a whole bunch of new IPs, or they've gotten some IPs from other places. And this one is the Conjuring Universe. So I'm very excited about this haunted house tonight. Definitely one of the ones that I'm going to prioritize, because the Conjuring Universe is a really, really cool franchise. So I'm looking forward to seeing what they do with this haunted house here. So it's taking over Buried Alive. Buried Alive, it was also time for that to go too. So even though I would say that's probably the more intense haunted houses, hopefully Conjuring is a lot more intense than Buried Alive ever was. So I'm super excited for this house tonight. I am going to do this one second. There is another one that I am prioritizing, and you'll probably see why here in just a minute. But yeah. But this is where all of our Dead Ender friends are going to be around here. So Hyde and all of them. So I don't know. I heard a bunch of the Dead Enders are actually not coming back this year, which kind of sucks. But I'm looking forward to seeing the scares over here. This is also where they have the robot. And look at the guy over there. Oh, cool. So that was a guy that was over, a statue that was over in Soul Harvest for the past couple years. It looks like they have moved him over here to the Scream Pumpkins scare zone. This is also going to be where the arrival is happening tonight, where all the scare actors will ride in on Miss Kitty, the train, and enter right through here and scare in this area until they go to their respective scare zones. So that will signify the start of Hallow Scream tonight. And speaking of scary, Daredevil Dive. I'm surprised it's actually open right now. It's pretty windy. Usually they close all the rides for wind, but I guess not Dare. So, but yeah, the arrival is tonight. I am so excited. This is going to be amazing. Look at this guy here. He's pretty cool. Oh, a little spider hanging off of him too. I don't know if we've had that before, but I never noticed that before. But yeah, this guy looks awesome. You can see some more netting and stuff over here on Thirsty Buffalo. Also some more theming around as well. Oh baby, Fright Fest is back, man. I'm so excited. So a Fright Fest tradition here at Fiesta Texas, they dye the water of Gully Washer red. And it's actually open, which is pretty surprising. It's been closed for every time that I've come this summer, it's been closed. But yeah, they finally got it open, which is pretty cool. And they have dyed the water red, which is the best part. So there used to be a haunt over here called Blood Bayou back in 2019 when I first started doing stuff. Oh, Gully Washer has a new sign over there. I didn't even notice that. Look at that. That's pretty cool. But yeah. They used to have something called Blood Bayou, which basically like, it was kind of like an extreme scare zone. You walk through the queue of Gully Washer, but it was bloody, hence the water. So yeah, always a nice tradition to have back at Fright Fest. Excited to see it. So we're passing over by Lone Star Lil's, where a majority of the entertainment's going to be tonight. You can see they already have the setup for Frightful Finale, which is the big fireworks show. It's going to be happening over here with some fireworks later on tonight. And something new they're also doing this year is with the release of the new Beetlejuice movie, Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, they're actually working with Fanta, the soda company, to do a special drone show for the Beetlejuice movie, which is really, really cool. So yeah, I'm also excited to come back here for Rock Apocalypse Anthems, which is a new show, but not really. We had Rock Apocalypse Revenge last year. It made its grand return after a few years. And now this year it's Rock Apocalypse Anthems, hopefully with some new songs. So I'm very excited to see what that is all about. And of course, Bloodletting is back. Bloodletting is back. Monster Mash Bash, the Bloodletting. We could go over in the cliffhanger queue and go check out the set and all, but I don't want to do that right now. I'm all over here. I don't want to go back there. So, but yeah, I'm excited to see what they have for Bloodletting. Is it going to be the same show? Is it going to be different? It's probably going to be a different show, but I'm super excited nonetheless for the return of Monster Mash Bash, the Bloodletting. Can't wait for all your entertainment tonight. Starts at 8 o'clock is Anthems, and then Bloodletting's at 9. They have the drone show later on at like 9:45, and then 10 o'clock is Frightful Finale over here. So I'm very excited for the entertainment. This is going to be awesome, guys. I'm so excited. For those guys who don't know, the entertainment, all the shows and stuff is my favorite part of Fright Fest. So I'm very excited to have all this awesome stuff back and see who we have as new performers this year, who is returning. I know there's a lot of returning performers this year that I'm very excited for. But yeah, here we go, man. Fright Fest is back, baby. I'm so excited. Over there is Kid Flash, which is not open right now. It actually had an accident a few months ago. It's basically been standing but not operating since. So I've only ridden this a handful of times. I've not been on this very often, but hopefully they can get it up and running because it has not been very successful thus far. But check out the little tunnel over here with all the pumpkins and stuff. Oh, they had a bunch of like Looney Tunes pumpkins and stuff last year. I'm wondering if they're gonna, if they have any of them in here this year. Oh, I see a Taz one right there. There's Taz. Are there any other ones? I know there was a bunch of them last year. I'm looking. So one thing that is steadily being constructed on is DC Universe, and they actually have a couple of new rides already up as we speak, or they're working on a couple of new rides as well. Looks like they have what's now called Green Lantern Emerald Flight, which is the old Zoom Jets, basically a rethemed version of Zoom Jets, up right now. And then this little thing right here is the monorail, as everyone keeps joking about. So the Metropolis Transit Authority, or whatever heck it's called, is a little monorail. It's like a 5-minute ride that goes all the way around DC Universe. So, and then we also have the Cyborg ride here too. That looks cool. So I've seen it before, but this looks incredible. I'm very, very excited for DC Universe to open up later on this year. This is awesome. You can see they're still doing a lot of active work over there in the construction site. Still working on a majority of the rides here. This one's gonna be a Poison Ivy ride. It's gonna be themed to Poison Ivy. We also have a little Cars ride back there. It's gonna be themed to the Penguin. And they finally got this one up, is the Batgirl Coaster Chase, which is the rethemed Streamliner coaster. That's pretty cool. I'm very excited. Look at the trains are kind of cool too. You can see more of the monorail up here too. So yeah, they haven't put in the Shazam ride yet, but they're working on it. Hi, Michael! So we are approaching a lot of the new stuff for this year, the Festival of Fright. Also found some friends over here. Hello, Michael. Hello, Loops and Splashdown family. What's up, guys? All right, look at all this cool stuff in here. Oh my gosh. Wow. I love this stuff in here. So this area is going to function as kind of like a place for Boo Fest and also stuff for Fright Fest tonight. So I'm interested to see how they're going to transform it to for the Fright Fest stuff. But look at all this awesome stuff over here. This is cool. Anybody home? Anybody in there? No? Anybody home? Right? Ding dong? Right. Look at all this cool. This is so cool. Twinkle tweet. Wow, look at this stuff. This is cool. This is very clever. Oh, do they have people over there? Oh yeah, for Boo Fest and stuff. Yeah. Wow, this is awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what I am most excited for tonight. We have a Stranger Things house at Fiesta Texas. I know, I can't believe it either. So they've basically taken out Rockkill High and they are transforming it into a Stranger Things themed house. And I am excited to see what is happening in the Upside Down later on tonight. Look, they even have the Hawkins High School flags. Oh, go Tigers. Awesome. I'm so excited, guys. This is gonna be awesome. And of course the bus is back. The bus is gonna freak the heck out of me later on today. This thing always gets me, but. So no infestation this year. They took it out in favor of Festival of Fright, but I'm interested to see how this is gonna function as a scare zone this year. You excited for Stranger Things, Michael? Yeah, that's my first stop tonight. As soon as it opens, I'm going. They do have a little infestation Easter egg over here by the Scream. All the stuff that was over in the infestation scare zone, but now it's been taken over by Festival of Fright. Sadness. So here's another little fun show happening later today. The Heebie Jeebies is a new kind of Boo Fest show. Trying to talk over the dudes for Scream over there, but they also have a little UFO over here with some infestation, but this is another show happening later on today, and I'm assuming it's going to be the cast of Rock Apocalypse, Anthems, not Revenge anymore. I said I'm doing this since everybody else is doing Haunted Hollywood, but oh man, I'm excited for this show. Hopefully they don't move it inside after Bubble Pop. This is where the Bubble Pop stuff was during the summer. And it was really, really hot outside, so they moved a lot of their shows indoors to Sanger Fest. So, I think they're doing the German bands in there this year, though, right? So that's gonna be kind of hard. But yeah, heebie-jeebies, I'm excited for it later on today. There's also the Oktoberfest stuff going on over in this area, too, since Spazberg. Makes sense, it's German themed. So, they got this dude over here. I've always called this guy, he looks like Uncle Vernon from Harry Potter. I mean, come on. Except he has significantly more hair than Uncle Vernon does. But yeah. Oh, look at all the Oktoberfest stuff in here. This is cool. Look at that. And then we got Trapped over here too. They basically took over the arcade. It is now a haunted house called Trapped. Trapped's been open for a couple of years now. But yeah, it's a pretty fun house. So maybe if I have time to get to it tonight, I'll check it out. But I don't know. Then we got more stuff happening inside of Spotsburg. I'm guessing they have the worst band again. The German band that plays. But yeah. Then we got Wicked Hollow. But now we're back in Wicked Hollow. And it's Bozak, the boy! I've always named him Bozak. It's his name. But look at all these guys in here. Wicked Hollow is Wicked Hollow. It's the same old. But yeah, I'm excited to see this place come alive later on tonight. It was pretty good last year. Wicked Hollow was pretty solid last year. Look at this guy. That's pretty cool. I didn't even notice the whale and then freaking General Grievous over here. But yeah, Wicked Hollow I think was one of the better scare zones last year. So I'm excited to see it return this year. Love this place, man. It's pretty awesome. I'm loving the new sign here for House of Hungen. The last of the houses we haven't seen yet. Oh, well, except for the stuff on the boardwalk, but it's not open yet. But House of Hungen is another house over here. And then during the day, they're going to have House of Curiosities, where someone leads you through House of Hungen with no scare actors. So I missed the show that was back there, the little show from Mardi Gras. What was the name of that show? What was the show called? The one that was back here? Madam Voodoo or whatever. I don't remember the name of it, but it was good. The one that had Black Magic in it. The little mix song. But yeah, that's pretty much all the Fright Fest and Boo Fest for now. The boardwalk's not open yet, so we'll go to the boardwalk later on today when it opens, which is, I have no idea what time it opens. It always opens late, so probably, I think like noon or something is when they usually open it, so yeah. All right, guys, it is now time for the first show today. It's Fiesta de los Muertos. Excuse you. I'm just pulling your finger, man. But yeah. This is the first show. Very exciting. You guys ready for the show?
Yeah.
Tyler, you ready? Matthew, you ready?
Yeah.
Matthew's gonna post the whole thing, so check out his channel for the full recording. Probably shooting the first and last show. It's just gonna be, those ones gonna be just the mariachis, so that's all right, but exciting. I will say, guys, the stage looks absolutely gorgeous. It looks very pretty. But yeah, I'm excited. Folks that are dressed up for the area over here. It's pretty cool. And you can. Oh, and the speakers are playing the audio from the show over there. Interesting. Alright, guys, we just finished watching about 20 minutes worth of that mariachi show. It's probably gonna go on until 1:30, but I wanna go watch the first Heebie Jeebies show over by Rockville. But yeah, it was pretty. The 20 minutes that I did watch were pretty good. It wasn't too bad. You know, it's the mariachis, so. It's not the coolest show in the world, but I do like when they put the candles on their head and they dance the candles on their head. That's pretty cool. But overall, it's pretty solid. So, Matthew and Michael and Tyler are gonna go get in line after that show to go watch Haunted Hollywood, which is at 2:30. But I'm gonna go watch Heebie Jeebies. So, yeah, I'm excited for that show. It's gonna be pretty cool. One of the things that Matthew and I were talking about when we were waiting for the show was these little stanchion signs give off serious Horror Nights vibes. So it's pretty cool. It gives people a good sense of where the houses are. So that's pretty cool. So like the trap thing is right here and the entrance is right there. Interesting. Oh, we're getting stopped by the train. And we're gonna bring back the tradition. I'm freeing a hand over here so that we can wave. In true Title Thrills tradition. We have to wave at the train when it comes by. Here comes Miss Kitty. In just a few hours, this train is going to be full with scare actors. Let me get a wave. Yay! Wave at the train. Yay! Nice to bring back old traditions. All right, we are here now at the Heebie-Jeebies stage. There's the band over there getting ready to come on. Oh, and there's... Oh, Xander's back. Xander and is that Priscilla? Oh, Priscilla too. Look at that. Wow. Welcome back, Xander and Priscilla. But yeah, ready for Heebie-Jeebies to start. Let's go. Got a couple of clips of y'all of Heebie-Jeebies there. Pretty awesome show. It's very, very cute. Catered towards kids, of course, it's Boo Fest stuff. But I kind of like it. So it kind of reminded me a little bit of the show from last year called Motley Ghouls, which was over in Crackaxle Canyon. Kind of reminded me of that a little bit. Mixture between that and the show called Terror Teatro that was for Hallowfest in 2020 and then eventually Fright Fest in 2021 when that came back. But it was pretty cool. I really enjoyed the show. Xander and Priscilla did a fantastic job. Happy to have both those two back. And yeah, Bam was pretty cool though. Where I was sitting, I couldn't see Kip at all. He was hiding behind the little TV screen. But yeah, that was very, very fun. The speakers were really, really loud. And one thing I also noticed too is that the performers and some of the band members had those little in-ear things. You know how like, you know, professional artists like Taylor Swift or Beyonce will have those little in-ears in their ears? They had some of them in their ears. I was like, huh, that's interesting. I've never seen them have those little in-ears before. But anyway, I liked that show a lot. It was pretty fun, pretty cute. But yeah, now it's time to get started with Haunted Hollywood. We're heading there right now. Show starts in about half an hour, and I'm so excited for Haunted Hollywood. Let's get it done. Head over to Zaragoza. All right, guys, we are here in Zaragoza Theater. We are about 25 minutes away from the first showing of Haunted Hollywood, and the energy is real. We are all super excited for this show. I'm interested to see what kind of songs they're going to have in this show. This is going to be awesome. I'm excited. Michael, you ready for Haunted Hollywood? Yeah. Matthew, you ready for Haunted Hollywood?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, I know. So they just did a big warning right as everyone started walking in. Like some kind of like viewer discretion is advised warning. So I'm like, they didn't put a PG-13 rating on this show, did they? Be funny. Apparently, right? All right. Here we go, guys. We're so excited.
Yeah.
We just got out of Haunted Hollywood. What did you guys think?
That was incredible.
It was unreal. Some of those numbers they did were really, really good, and it was pretty cool to see some returning fan favorite cast members come back, like Ali and Imani. That was awesome. Matthew, what'd you think, dude?
Alrighty.
What'd you think?
Really good. 10 out of 10.
10 out of 10. Yeah, we said 10 out of 10, but River Hollywood's a little better. A little bit better.
They took a quality over quantity.
It's amazing. Yeah. Oh, man. What a time. All right, we're actually going to go ahead and head into House of Curiosities right now, the Boo Fest version of House of Hoongin. So, yeah, I haven't done this in a while, actually. Let's go. All right, guys, just walked through House of Curiosities. What y'all think? It's just House of Hoongin, but with no scares. Just walking through, and there's three girls in there that guide you around and show off their very dead relatives. So, yeah.
Dead and mangled.
I know, dead and mangled and touching skulls, apparently. Yeah. All right, so we've made our way over to the boardwalk, because the boardwalk has since opened since we last walked around. So, right now we are in... What is this? Oh, Carnival of Terror. I almost forgot the name of the zone for a second. Carnival of Terror. This one has a couple of kind of pop-up places like this. There's one over here, a couple over here too. Oh, they have more stuff this year. That's kind of nice. But yeah, it looks like they have a lot more props and stuff up this year than they had before. I see some stuff over there. But here, the scare actors kind of just like maneuver around. And the clowns over here, they go pretty hard. This is where Jekyll is. And Jekyll is definitely one of the better scare actors at this park. So I'm excited to see Jekyll and Tiny and Chains and everybody. And then, of course, we have the house that debuted last year, Twisted Theater of Torment, which Pandemonium is closed right now for, looks like, maintenance issues. But Twisted is going to be open later on tonight. I'm very excited about Twisted. I don't know if I'll go through it tonight. That may be a tomorrow night thing, but Twisted's pretty cool. It did pretty well last year, so I'm glad it's back again this year. But yeah, ready for Jekyll to come out tonight, Michael? Jekyll, the boy. But yeah, Look at this little thing over here. That's pretty cool. I know, that's kind of cool. Yeah, so it's pretty obvious that a lot of these scare actors are going to be inside these little booths throughout the night. So I don't remember this one being here last year, though. Oh, this was, oh yeah, this was Jekyll's one last year. I remember, yeah. You see the little logo up there? But yeah. Guys, this is all just still so surreal. I cannot believe we have a Stranger Things house out our park. It is unbelievable. I'm so excited for this. This is gonna be like probably my favorite part of the night. I really hope it lives up to the hype. I really hope. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited for this. That is going to end part one of my first Fright Fest video this year. I am splitting them up this year. It's the first one. It is kind of the calm before the storm and some of the shows in the beginning of the day. And then starting around like 6 o'clock that night is when all the Fright Fest stuff starts. So we do some of the houses and we do some of the scary zones. As you guys can tell, I am losing my voice because of how awesome Fright Fest was. And you guys will see that in the next video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe if you're new to the channel. And I'll catch you guys for the next video. Peace out.